knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
After spending some time looking at T cells, it's time to switch our focus over to B cells. B cells and the antibodies they produce are the central elements of humoral immunity. It is known that defects in B cell development, selection, and function may lead to disorders such as autoimmunity, malignancy, immunodeficiencies, and allergy. B cells originate from hematopoietic stem cells, or HSCs, and undergo several developmental stages, including early lymphoid progenitor, common lymphoid progenitor, pro-B and pre-B cells within the bone marrow, and transitional B cells in the peripheral lymphoid organs, before developing into mature B cells. Circulating through the body in the bloodstream and lymph, B cells regularly visit secondary lymphoid organs, such as the spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, Peyer's patches, and mucosal tissues. Movement toward B cell follicles, formation of germinal centers or GCs, and egress from tissues back to the circulation are regulated by adhesion molecules and by the interplay between different G protein coupled receptors. Recombination activating gene or RAG, 1-2 dependent rearrangement of the V chain, D gene, and J gene segments from germline follows in the early pre-B cell stage. IL-7R signaling through the JAK1, 3, and STAT5AB pathway is critical for pro-B cell survival and proliferation. However, once the rearrangement of genes encoding the immunoglobulin heavy chain succeeds and pre-B cells are formed, IL-7R signaling needs to be attenuated. Pre-B cells continue to depend on IL-7 for proliferation and expression of anti-apoptotic genes, such as BCL2, BCL2L1, and MCL1. However, excessive IL-7R signaling arrests pre-B cell development into the immature B cell stage due to a near-complete block in the rearrangement of Ig light chain genes. IgM, expressed by immature B cells, changes the expression pattern of many genes and initiates egress into the circulation. Immature B cells enter the spleen as transitional B cells, where they receive survival signals through B cell activating factor receptor, or BAFF-R, and complete the first stage of development as either marginal zone B cells or follicular B cells, depending on the specificity of their B cell receptor, or BCR. On contact with antigen and supported by B cell helper neutrophils, or NBH, B cells in the marginal zone of the spleen develop into short-lived plasma cells, or PCs. Follicular B cells are activated by antigen binding and develop in germinal centers into memory B cells, or plasma cells. Plasma cells release antibodies in response to antigens. Once a B cell becomes a mature plasma cell, it can release up to thousands of antibodies per second. Plasma cells are also called plasmacytes or effector cells. They have a shorter lifespan than memory cells. Memory cells retain specific antigens, enabling the immune system to swiftly launch a defense upon their reappearance in the body. Unlike plasma cells, which combat intruders by generating antibodies, memory cells contribute to future immune responses. This mechanism is evident in vaccine efficacy as they prime the immune system with antigens that memory cells store for rapid mobilization in the event of an invasion. An antigen-presenting cell, APC, binds to the antigen, fragmenting it into smaller segments. These antigen pieces are then affixed to molecules known as major histocompatibility 2 complexes, MHC2. Helper T cells, a subtype of T cell, adhere to the MHC2 complex, triggering their activation. Activated helper T cells play a crucial role as they stimulate the initiation of B cell responses. An activated T cell binds to a B cell, prompting the latter to undergo replication, generating clones. Some of these B cells mature into plasma cells capable of synthesizing antibodies, while others differentiate into memory cells, which are retained within the body. Over the subsequent days, plasma cells produce millions of antibodies, each tailored to target solely the specific pathogen associated with the antigen. If immature B cells bind to self-antigens, they can undergo secondary genetic rearrangement to generate new specificities with lower affinity to self-antigens. Strongly binding cells will die in the bone marrow. All other cells emigrate to the spleen, where BCRs bind to self-antigens with various affinities. Intermediate binding can lead to functional anergy, meaning absence of normal immune response, while strong binding can lead to exclusion from B-cell follicles. This mechanism might account for the generation of autoreactive B-cells in patients with autoimmune diseases. Class switching, also known as isotype switching or antibody class switching, is a process that occurs in B-cells during the maturation of the immune response. B-cells initially produce immunoglobulin M, or IgM, antibodies upon encountering an antigen. However, through class switching, B-cells can change the class of antibody they produce without changing their antigen specificity. The different classes of antibodies, such as IgG, IgA, and IgE, have distinct functions and properties. During class switching, the constant region of the antibody molecule, or the portion that remains the same regardless of the antibody's specificity, is altered, resulting in the production of antibodies with different effector functions. This process is mediated by enzymes called activation-induced cytidine deaminases, or AID, which induce DNA rearrangements in the immunoglobulin gene locus. By undergoing class switching, B cells can tailor the immune response to better combat specific types of pathogens or antigens. Functions of the different isotypes are as follows. IgA is found abundantly in both mice and humans. This antibody isotype is predominantly present in mucosal sites such as the gut, respiratory tract, and urogenital tract, where it functions to prevent the colonization of pathogens. Notably resistant to digestion, it is also secreted in milk. With IgD, the function is unclear. It works with IgM in B cell development and is mainly B cell bound. IgE is responsible for binding to allergens, initiating the release of histamine from mast cells and contributing to allergic reactions. This antibody isotype also plays a role in defending against parasitic worms. IgG constitutes approximately 75% of the total serum antibodies in humans, so this Ig is the most prevalent in serum. It is primarily responsible for furnishing the bulk of antibody-mediated immunity against invading pathogens and exhibits moderate complement fixation capabilities. And finally, IgM. As the initial responder antibody, it is expressed both on the surface of B cells and in a secreted form, boasting exceptionally high avidity, or cumulative strength of multiple affinities. Its primary function is to eradicate pathogens during the early phases of B cell-mediated immunity, prior to the development of adequate levels of IgG. And with that, we conclude an introduction to the cell types of the adaptive immunity, and to our study of the immune system in general.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.